Who's coming?
Yeah, just thankful. Of course, a coach thinks about the field first. Man, a Penn team that's won 8 straight and just absolutely dominated their region. Southern Miss and Scott Berry already announcing his retirement. And, Coach Oz is going to Oscar and gets the opportunity to lead that program. And I know Southern Miss, how they want to go out after another great season. And then Samford, a team that won 3 games in one day to get the automatic qualifier, I'm very well aware. We've played Samford. That's the one team in this field that we've already played this year. And I know how Tony David runs his show and how successful that program's been. So 3 proud schools, 3 schools that are playing great, which you'll find at this point in time of the season anyway. So we're excited to host them in Auburn. And I guess the biggest takeaway for a second before you get right back in the preparation phase, it's just the first time in our program's history, Auburn baseball, to host back-to-back regionals at Plainsman Park is a big, big deal. And a credit to our assistant coaches, all of our staff, and these amazing players of breeding some consistency in the program. And, last year was pretty special here, and to be able to do it again, I'm looking forward to it. I've been in the league for a long time as an assistant. I would say we had a feel of what a template would be, although this college baseball is changing quickly, and it is different. But I think about Brian Shoup, I think about David Perno, I think about Tom Slater, I think about John Cohen. I've been fortunate enough to work for 3 national head coaches of the year in our country. So that preparation, this is an opportunity to answer a question and give them a lot of credit. And I just think being in the space for a long time as an assistant coach, you had a feel of what the template would be. And hopefully the best is yet to come. There's a lot of boxes we still haven't checked. But at the same time, I guess the last piece would be I was here for 3 years as an assistant at Auburn. And it almost took a decade to get back and get this opportunity. And I think there was a lot of preparation, not only from the people that I coached for, but from my own personal time here at Auburn before.
Coach, you had a team that's already been in the College World Series a year ago. You got a large number of those guys back. How valuable is that experience that they had getting to that point, and how do you think that'll help your run this year?
Well, things are possible, but I can't tell you how incredibly difficult it is to get there. Even to get to this stage, to be able to host, be one of the 16 teams to host. There'll be a lot of roadblocks. It's been hard to get here. I always think those 10 weeks of SEC play are the best preparation when you've played the number 1, the number 2 team, and 2 number 3 teams at the time we played them. That's real preparation for what's ahead of you. So I know it'll continue to be hard, but I know we're prepared. I even look at an Indiana and a Southern Cal that we had brought in here earlier. This schedule really probably provided opportunities for us. And I'm hoping as a coach that it's the preparation that is hopefully needed to hook it up and play your best baseball of the season right now.
Butch, did y'all make it to the lake? And how important was that downtime, you think, for your program?
We just took a day off. We wound up playing 3 games in the tournament this year, so there was not as much downtime. So we did get the 36, 40 hours there. Got back out on the field. We did a squad game yesterday to let the throwers. You can't go between when we exited the SEC tournament and get into a region without having at bats and pitchers throwing the hitters. So we'll do the second squad game today. We'll do an early practice and start tapering our practice activities. And we'll actually be up at Lake Martin tomorrow. Memorial Day is kind of a tough time to go out there and fight all those boats and people on Memorial Day. So the day after might be a little quieter out there tomorrow, and we'll get out there tomorrow afternoon and spend some time around the dock and some good food. We'll get some Oscars, we'll get some catfish in us, and we might even get the pontoon boat to bring some ice cream and stuff in. So we got a good few hours set after a good practice tomorrow. So Lake Martin, here we come.
You talked about benchmarks for the program, and one of those was getting a regional here to now do it back-to-back. I mean, how special is it now that you can kind of
say that? Yeah, so, and like I said, when I say it's incredibly hard, I remember 2018 and the metrics that we had and had to go on the road, and you're waiting and fighting. So I understand all these teams that get the draw or don't get the draw. I understand. I've lived it for you know, a lot of our career and stuff. So, but just for this community, you know, I heard from our mayor. I heard from, you know, just, I know the impact. That's just an example of the impact that you hear from. You hear from the football coach. You hear from people in this community and people that have worn this uniform before. That is a big deal to have it here at home. And a lot more people that are going to visit the Frank Thomas statue this coming week.
Appreciate it.